Now, to score goals, we of course need a goal. So let's add a goal class. We give it an initial size, initialize the pulse rate, the speed, set the color and some goal count. In the time step, we simply set the speed to 0 because we don't want to move the goal. And in score, we add a 1 to the goal count. And we make the radius of the goal a little smaller. So if you score, it gets harder to score because the goal gets smaller. And we draw the goal with a particular color. So here we add a goals list to put our goals in. And similar to the player objects, we add 2 goal objects. Same colors, blue and green. And then in the time step function, we also have to loop over all the goals. And then in the check and handle collision function, we get the following. So we test if the first object is a ball and the second object is a goal. If that is the case, then we score on object 2. So the goal gets a point. And if the object 1 is in the balls class, we remove it, because we remove a ball when it scores a goal. Let's see if that works. Yeah, so now it works. We score, the goal gets a little smaller. Oh, it's a difficult game. But we have to have some counting of the goals, I think. Let's see, how can we do that? We'll create some markers. Set the width and the height. And then in our draw function, we can loop over the current goal count and put a line there in red for every goal that was scored. Let's see. Yeah, 1 goal, 2, 3, but I think scoring a goal should be more spectacular, so let's add an explosion. So first the size of the explosion when a goal is scored. So there's a goal time variable, that is the time since the last goal was scored. Every time step it is subtracted by 1. And if a goal is scored, we set the goal time equal to the collision radius. And then if the goal time is still larger than 0, we compute the time like this. So the current goal time, the collision radius min the goal time, times 4, and then we draw an oval. Let's see if that works out. Yeah, looks better. I think we already created a nice game. I've also added bullets, but I don't want to cover this in the video because it's very similar to the dynamics of the balls. Yeah, if you like this game, go practice and challenge me. In the next video, we'll start with our next game.